Hi everyone, this is Scott with Drudge Multimedia. This episode covers one of the many WordPress plugins available for creating photo galleries for your website. This plugin is the NextGen Gallery plugin, and basic out-of-the-box version offers quite a bit of good quality options to create a responsive design. I ran various testing on a few different web hosting providers before committing to using NextGen for gallery presentation. NextGen claims to be one of the most downloaded plugins available, with a fair number of negative responses, and before recommending to my clients, I had to test and review. With that said, let's begin. Setting up a new gallery as I'll outline here is a quick and easy process. For this demo, we're using the NextGen Gallery plugin, a custom sidebar plugin like Simple Page Sidebars, my custom DMM Update Gallery Descriptions plugin. This little plugin updates the caption field with a copy of the file name. You probably don't need this feature, but for my demo, this was a requirement to have this caption field populated after a gallery was created. And an FTP program like FileZilla. We'll assume that you have most of the above installed and configured. Otherwise, I'll cover in separate tutorials on how to set those up. So to begin, log into your WordPress admin section and select Manage Galleries from the left menu. Click on the Add New Gallery button and enter the new gallery name. Once the gallery has been created, you can either use the internal drag and drop to upload images, or I think it's much faster to use the FTP and upload a few hundred images all at once. Using the internal drag and drop should be straightforward and easy to use, so I'm not going to cover it in this session. Open your favorite FTP program. If you do not have an FTP program, go get one like FileZilla. I'll cover downloading and setting up FileZilla in a separate tutorial. Connect to your site and you can quickly upload a bunch of images to the gallery. This is much faster than using the gallery uploader, I think. The right window in FileZilla represents your hosted site. Browse to the gallery folder that was created by NextGen. Typically, it will be under the root, then WP Content, Gallery, and then for this example, mine is called DMM Gallery 1. If you don't see the new gallery folder, try refreshing by right-clicking and seeing if it appears. If it doesn't, then maybe you didn't save the new gallery, so hop back over to WordPress and check. The left window in FileZilla represents your local drives. It works a lot like the Windows File Manager or the Mac Finder. You can close FileZilla or leave it open to upload more images later. I'd really suggest you don't do more than, say, a few hundred images at a time. You'll see why in a moment. Now switch back over to WordPress, then the Gallery Manager, and select the gallery you are adding images to. Click on the Scan folder for new images. Shortly after clicking, a pop-up will be shown processing the images. Be patient, and only click the button once. It may take a few minutes for the site to respond, depending upon how many images you have uploaded. The scan is slow because the server has to take every image you upload and create a thumbnail version. Once completed, the list will be updated and you'll see your images. Notice that the description field is empty. This is the caption that is placed below the image when clicked on by a user browsing your gallery. You could go through and hand enter every description, or in my case, I want to display the actual file name. So I wrote a simple plugin called Update Gallery Descriptions. This will update any empty descriptions in any gallery, and a pop-up will indicate the number updated. Click OK, and you'll be returned to the page where you were on when you clicked the Update Gallery Description link. You may or may not see the updated descriptions until you return to the gallery again. The next step is to create a page that shows the gallery on your site. Simply click the Add Page button, and a page will be created with the gallery title. You can change the name page later if you like. The page will show as linked to the gallery. Browse to the page created and you will see that a shortcode was created that links the gallery to this page. Change the page title if you desire to have it named to something else, or you can leave it as is. This site's current template uses a sidebar by default. The Simple Sidebar plugin allows us to create custom sidebars for any page or to use the default, or change the template to one without a sidebar. Scroll down on the right and change the sidebar to a custom sidebar, or change the template. This one currently uses the Order Form widget, which is populated with the How to Order content. You can update this in the Appearances Widgets section. Go to Menus. Check the item to add to the top menu. Drag the menu added under the parent menu, and it should snap into place. Then save the menu changes. At this point, you are done, and your new gallery is live. Browse the site and view the gallery. So this tutorial quickly covered how to create a new gallery, add images, and make that gallery live. I hope this helps you get started in creating your WordPress galleries. For more help tips, visit my website at drudgemm.com or find us on YouTube. I'm Scott Drudge, and have a great day.